Long ago, towards the beginning of Legacy on ARK PS4, a megatribe was formed. This megatribe ended up becoming one of the most feared in all of ARK PS4. The tribe eventually faded away, but from the time they began to the time they reached their end, they became one of the most feared in the council community. The leader will go down as a legend and be remembered by the community until the end of ARK's journey. This tribe was one of the first mega tribes on ARK PS4. They were responsible for many server wipes, and during their prime were considered the strongest of all other tribes. They were the first tribe to make a channel on PS4, and that channel became a favorite in the community. Although the community never received a proper closure from the tribe, ARK PS4 would have never been the same without them. This will be the start of a new series focusing on the history of ARK PS4's most popular mega tribes. Our first episode will be focusing on perhaps the most famous mega tribe of them all. The most loved, the most hated, the legendary UC Gaming. Enjoy. To understand the story of UC, we must take it back to the beginning of Legacy servers. InnoVision and his work colleague decided to start a tribe on console. Both players had come from PC and decided to create a tribe. Originally, Inno did not want to come to PS4 at all because he had quit ARK, but his friend convinced him otherwise. InnoVision went under the tribe name Ascension during the beginning months of ARK's release on PS4. Originally, before Umbrella Corp, before Unchained Gaming, they went under the tribe name Ascension. The original server of Ascension was server 253 The Island. Do not get this server confused with 253 Wild Ones, which happened far more into the story on the new servers. Inno managed to secure server 253 practically instantaneously and wiped anyone who refused to join him. When Ascension was first formed, the original count was around 30 to 40 players. Inno's plan from the start was to attack other servers through the cross-server rating system and wipe them. InnoVision was trying to unify the server and give the tribes on server 253 a choice. Either they joined him and they stood as one server, or you would be wiped. A player by the name of Big Hall refused to listen to Inno and fled to a new server under the lead of Captain Kush. That server was 819. A few weeks after this happened, Big Hall came back to server 253 and asked Inno if he would help them defend. Inno couldn't pass up on the offer, so him and his tribe members went to help defend and quickly pushed off Captain Kush's attackers. 3 weeks after this, Captain Kush hit up Inno and asked him if he could wipe server 819, which would in return lead to a closer relationship between Inno and Captain Kush. Captain Kush wanted this to happen so he could gain complete control of the server. This would make the first server wipe of UC and would later lead to something much, much bigger. Inno and Ascension helped wipe the server, leaving only Fifi Rampage, Legion of Doom, which was Kush's tribe, and Genesis, which belonged to the player Icon. For about a month, things were settled and calm, and things were mostly peaceful. ARK PS4 was around 4 months into release and the game was becoming quite popular. Unfortunately, around this time, Legion of Doom, Captain Kush's tribe, was completely incited by the co-leader. After this, Kush took the tribe and went to Scorched Earth. Inno and Kush were still talking at the time and they were quite close, and during this time, the Valentine's Day event came to PS4, and this was the first Valentine's Day event in, I believe, in console in general. Inno and Kush's tribes mass bred, which led to a merge between tribes later on. This is what bloomed the start of UC gaming. It's important to understand that Inno was bringing things to console that had not been seen or heard of ever before. Inno's intention was to bring mass numbers to servers, which at this time was unheard of in the console community. During this time, Kush and Inno were still leading separate tribes, but Inno was trying to get Kush to merge into his. Some time passed, and eventually Inno convinced Kush to merge into his tribe. Inno's tribe had now become even more powerful, but they were still under the tribe name Ascension. Over the next couple of months, Inno and Kush worked well together, and prepared to wipe other servers. Inno was the official leader, and Kush was the co-leader during the time period. They spent countless hours raising, grinding, and preparing for cross-server raiding. They locked down their server, making it possibly one of the strongest servers on ARK PS4 at the time. Shortly after the merge, both Inno and Kush decided that it was time for a new name. They quickly decided to call the tribe Umbrella Corp. Inno told his members that the tribe name Ascension was nothing more than a name until they had risen to the top. The name Umbrella Corp came from Inno's time on PC. Not too long after this, Inno told his members that the time had come and they were going to wipe a server. He picked a random server, being server 233, and joined it. Inno typed in global and asked who the top tribe was on the server, and a player by the name of Bongrips spoke up. Inno told Bongrips to give him ownership of every single tribe on the server and become a part of UC, or he was going to wipe the server. Bongrips told Inno to pull up and to give it your best shot. He told Inno that he'd be waiting. Inno responded with, "I will see you in 6 hours." Inno and Umbrella Corp wiped the entire server but one base. Inno left the last base on the server and told Bongrips that he had 24 hours to reconsider or he would be back to finish it off. Bongrips tore the base down and moved to another server. The next day, the server that Bongrips had joined was trying to wipe him off. He then sought out UC's help and offered to join in exchange for them helping save all of his stuff. This marked the time period where Bongrips would merge into Umbrella Corp, making the tribe even stronger. Although UC ended up wiping this server, the relationship between Bongrips' members and UC Gaming grew stronger, further growing the tribe. Also, this server wipe marked the first wipe that UC Gaming had ever uploaded on their channel, called March of the Littlefoot. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the March of the Littlefoot.
Get the
After the wipe of server 233, UC returned back to 253. About a month went by, and one of the members in UC told Inno about a new potential server they could hit. They scouted the server, and that server was 492. UC made preparations, and the server was flooded. At this point in time, UC had around 70 active members. This was their second server wipe, and it was uploaded to the UC channel on May 11th, 2017. The video reached almost 50,000 views. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the reckoning of server 492. Reached out a hand to touch your face. You're slowly disappearing from my After another successful wipe, UC Gaming returned back to their home server, but things didn't stay calm for long. Some griefers attacked 253 with a small fob, but were quickly pushed off by UC. Not long after, UC learned that the griefers were from server 524. The reason for the griefers coming to the server was because a member from 524 left the server to join UC. That member was named Bullseye Bandit. UC gathered their teams and equipment and flooded server 524. Only a few days after the attack on their server, at this point in time, UC had a little over 100 members. On May 23rd, 2017, UC uploaded The Wipe of 524. This was one of their most viewed videos and currently has almost 200,000 views. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you The Wipe of 524. Turn their heads and quickly look away. With the popularity of UC growing, other tribes were starting to recruit on massive levels. A tribe called Space Cowboys, who were much smaller than UC at the time, were making moves as well. They uploaded a YouTube video of them attacking a tribe, and that video went viral. From there, Inno contacted SC, and they were invited to join a raid with UC. No major alliances were formed, and that is basically how UC and SC's relationship remained throughout Legacy. I thought I might touch up on that because a lot of people thought UC and SC were very close allies on Legacy, but that was not the case. Other tribes were trying to create massive tribes like UC. One of those tribes was called Foxhound, a French mega tribe. UC went to grief one of their servers without knowing who they were. UC was quickly pushed off. After this, UC went to their main server and prepared for war, and a few days later, flooded the server and wiped it. The video was uploaded to their channel on June 11, 2017. The video was titled, The Death of Umbrella Corp. Foxhound claimed to have wiped UC, which was not the case, so it was a punch at them saying, "Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the wipe of Server 20. I ain't fragile, so don't cover me up. In bubble wrap, travel, find yourself at peace with that. Like where you at, you can't even see me, there's a gap between us, I know that you're nowhere on the map. Cause you ain't really got it, don't think that you understand, you're at your death. Yeah, yeah, if you can't even spot it, yeah, there's nothing more to say, boy, just a left. During the wipe of server 20, Foxhound told UC to pull up to server 140. This was Foxhound's main server. At this point in time, UC had 3 servers and a little over 140 members. UC flooded 140 and wiped it without any issues. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the wipe of Foxhound's main server, being 140. They call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm one. My mother was a tiger. She saw my new blue jeans. Some time passed after 140. A UC member went over to a server, which was 777. He found out that the alpha of the server made tribes pay tames and other items in order for them to be left alone. UC happened to pick up a few of those tribes, and while they were moving, the alphas of 777 began attacking them. UC decided to step in and wipe the server. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the wipe of 777.
Champion. Champion.
During this time, UC was the most talked about tribe in all of Council. They had managed to recruit over 300 people and had a total of 6 servers. Time passed and they were attacked by several tribes and every time remained the victor. UC were never wiped once on Legacy. They went back to server 140 and rewiped because Foxhound had slightly rebuilt. The next part of UC's journey was the wipe of server 345. The wipe of 345 was simply a wipe that UC were scouting. After the death of Chester Bennington, UC wanted to wipe a server and make a video in tribute. 345 had 4 massive bases on the server. All were wiped by Umbrella Corp. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the wipe of server 345. They're burning into the night. There's too many men, too many people making too many problems, and not much love to go around. Can't you see this is the land of confusion? After the wipe of 345, UC's next target was server 367. The tribe on 367 was called Dirty Boys. Inno joined 367 and asked who the Alpha was. They knew who Inno was and taunted him, telling him to rub their feet. Inno quote-unquote replied with, he would be rubbing their feet with a bunch of people. Other than that, there wasn't much a reason for wiping 367. UC wiped all of the bases on the server and added another successful wipe to their lists. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the wipe of server 367. I don't got time to look over my shoulder. Leave them all behind, I'm about to take over. You want a good competitor? But I stay on top. Yeah, I call the shots, get used to it. Nothing's gonna bring me down. Feeling that adrenaline, the rush in my veins, fuel to the flame. I live for it. Nothing's gonna bring me down.
Fire on the ground, got him running for cover. Better watch out, I'm about to take over. I don't got time to look over my shoulder. Leave him all behind, I'm about to take over.
During this stage of UC, they had over 600 members and had at least 10 servers. The final wipe that UC did on Legacy was the wipe of ARK Psychos and Peach and Ice-T on server 776. This was towards the end of Legacy, and the new servers had been announced and were going to be released within the next few weeks. UC was looking for the biggest server they could possibly find, and they found one relatively quick. 776 was considered one of the strongest servers on PS4. The server was wiped by Umbrella Corp in 2 days, and all of the main bases on the server were wiped. At the end of Legacy, UC had more than 1,000 members and 17 servers. UC, the strongest tribe on ARK PS4 Legacy, had little to no damage done to them during their existence. I'd like to give a big shout out to the leaders of UC, being InnoVision and the Captain Kush. All of the information provided came directly from the leaders of UC. No other sources. There should not be anybody in the comments saying that this did not happen, because this came directly from the leaders. I'd like to give a big shout out to Ghost. After I announced the UC Gaming documentary, it started going downhill in a relatively quick downward spiral. Unfortunately, the original editor that I had partnered with on this video decided to quit, which meant that I had to scrap everything and start from the beginning due to copyright issues. I was just about to announce that I was done when Ghost messaged me on Discord proposing his offer to edit. And basically we hopped in a Discord call and we met, and I could not have done this without him. I told him, quote unquote, I said, "Listen, I don't make the best judgment all the time, so if I tell you something and you don't like it, don't tell me, just do it." And some of those things that he did that I basically, you know, in this situation, made this video so much more better, and it would not have been the same without him. So please go subscribe to his channel, which I will leave in the description. And for those of you wondering, yes, this is a two-part episodic series involving UC. This is Legacy. There will be a new servers. Now, I don't know how the new servers is going to work out, because unfortunately, one of the people who owns the right to the videos on towards the later end of Legacy may or may not get involved with copyright issues. So I promise you guys I will do my best. Yes, there will 100% be a part two to the UC Gaming documentary, which will be the final conclusion of it. And after that, we will move on to the other Mega Tribes in PS4. Vote in the comments what you guys want to see next. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you enjoyed, subscribe for more, and I'm out. Goodbye.